Hello and welcome to the TI reference design for vibration condition monitoring with the SimpleLink MSP432P4 host MCUs. Vibration analysis for motors and pumps may be used to detect rotary element faults like those arising due to bearing defects and defects on the inner and outer rays, faults due to axial and radial shaft misalignments, and failure of the motor mount at a very early stage. This demonstration is for the reference design TIDA01575 and is an example of a low-power, flexible, scalable wireless solution for vibration analysis of motors and pumps. The setup used for this demonstration is shown in this image. It comprises of the MSP432P4 launchpad with the industry's highest precision integrated ADC and the Boost XLCC2650 module booster pack running the SimpleLink Software Development Kit and Bluetooth plugin. The sensor is a 3-axis accelerometer KXTC93672 from Kionix with analog output that can be signal conditioned. The test motor is a standard 3-phase BLDC motor rotating at 3600 RPM or 60 cycles per second. The load is shown next. Finally, connecting the test motor and a load is a shaft. Now let us look at a demo of a working motor which has minimum vibration. The 3-axis accelerometer output is captured on an oscilloscope. In time domain, we see that there is an output. However, the information is not clear. The host MCU runs a 1024-point FFT on the sample data and uses the BLE module to transfer the data. As the next step, we shall use the SimpleLink SDK Explorer on a smartphone or tablet to read the FFT data. As can be seen in the frequency spectrum for X, Y, and Z axis, the fundamental component of the vibration is at 60 Hz. However, we also see substantial amplitude for the fifth harmonic on the X and Z plots, indicating some level of vibration outside the smooth operation of the motor. Next, we shall look at a failing setup for the same motor. There is some change in the audible noise output, and the signal looks different on a scope. Also, when we slow down the video, we can see that the shaft is wobbling about its own axis. However, the difference is not visible in time domain but in frequency domain. So let us connect our application and see the XYZ vibration frequency plots. As is clearly visible, the fundamental component is no longer having the maximum energy. Instead, the energy distribution has moved into the higher harmonics. With another failing setup, we shall now see how vibration patterns change. For this setup, we shall loosen the bolts holding down the test motor by half turns. At regular video speeds, we do not see a much of a difference. However, as we slow down the playback, the loose motor mount is causing the wobble on the shaft. The output on the app shows that the energy is even more wideband than earlier. Thank you for watching this demo for the vibration condition monitoring with SimpleLink MSP432P4 host MCU. Be sure to visit us at www.ti.com.